Thank you. Shall we all stand and sing our school song?
I myself just experienced my own graduation less than 2 years ago. It's still fresh in my mind. And I majored in education. I remember one of my assignments was to write the statement of philosophy. I highlighted most one word, that was serve. Today I want to especially ask God to bless you and help each one of you, prepare each one of you for the joy of service in both this world and the world to come. Let us pray. Gracious Father, they made it by your grace. I ask you to bless all the graduates today as they move forward to the next level of the adventure. Lord, we know they are not here at this academy by accident nor coincidence, but by your plan. Dear Lord, we know you have great plan on each one of them. They were born for the mission. They're here to be ready to make a difference in this world. I pray, Lord, you can give them extraordinary courage to hold fast to truth, to resist the evil tide of this world, to be a witness for you and on earth. I pray, Lord, that your spirit can stimulate their desire to dedicate their whole life to you, which will be the most meaningful life. I pray, Lord, that each one of them can be unique and keep their individuality in Christ, that all of them will never be blind followers, but wise young men and women with independent thinking and discernment. Lord, we don't know what they are going to face in the future. No parents, no teachers can accompany them to protect them, to teach them, to encourage them all the time. But God, You are able. Lord, no one can provide them answers to all questions, but Lord, you are able. No one can help them to always make wise decisions or detect the dangers and chances ahead, but you, my Lord, is able. Dear Lord, I just want to ask you to help them to invite you to their life as they journey through this life, no matter what decision they are going to make, no matter where they go, that help them never do and go without you. Thank you for listening to our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Family, friends, and students, a very important milestone that our grade 12, our seniors, have achieved is not a small milestone. It's actually a very important milestone. And thank you all for taking time to come and celebrate the 2022 high school graduation of Hong Kong Adventist Academy. Thank you for your time. Thank you for the impact that you have made on the lives of these young men and women that are seated here who are ready to graduate. I just have one or two announcements very quickly before we begin our program. The men's bathrooms or the men's restrooms are on my right. Okay, you need to walk out of the building and towards the entrance of the building, but on my right. And the ladies' bathrooms or the women's bathrooms or restrooms are on my left. Okay, that will be your right. Please do not walk around and take any pictures. We have photographers, our teachers and students, professional photographers, actually, they are. So they will come and take pictures of you and the ceremony. So please do not walk around and take any pictures. If you need a translation, there will be running translation available. The devices, the translating devices, are at the back. So please go at the back and ask for a device, or you can just raise your hand and then a device will be given to you. You get translation in Putonghua and Cantonese, I think. Right? Thank you very much. Please, once again, feel welcome. Thank you for taking time to come to witness the 2022 Hong Kong Adventist Academy Grade 12 graduation, high school graduation. Thank you.
Welcome to the HKAA class of 2022 graduation. I'm glad to see everyone here, even though due to the circumstances, I cannot be there physically. It's been 12 years since we started our studies. A lot of has changed since then. We have experienced many events in the world, such as the coronavirus, for example. And frankly, the world has changed quite a bit. But more than the world, we have changed over ourselves. For 12 years, we have been forming, growing, and developing as individuals. And now we are ready to go to adulthood on our own. But that is not what my message is about. I just want to say that I was so happy to learn with all of the students in my class, and also was happy to be taught by HKAA school teachers. I am proud to be a part of this class, and I am also proud to be a student at this school. I want to say thank you to all of the students and teachers who were there the entire time, and thank you to everyone who came to attend this event. God bless you, and I will see you around.
Our scripture reading for this graduation ceremony is taken from Proverbs 27, verse 17. As iron sharpens iron, so so one sharpens another.
Steve, graduating class of 2022, parent, Principal Decker, Mr. Steve, graduating class of 2022, parents,
hello, everybody.
Guests, all those who came to honor.
I think we're trying to get the video up and running. I recorded my address for you.
I've worked so hard to finally graduate. It's my honor to speak to you today. To the graduating class, I'm amazed you want to hear from me again, but I'm honored. Thank you for this opportunity. To the graduating class, you finally made it to the beginning. You thought this was the end, but this is actually the beginning. This, you see in your program, is a commencement service, and commencement means to begin. Everything up to this point has been practice. My sister teaches music, and she told me a few years ago that she'd realized that our normal saying is wrong. Practice doesn't make perfect. Practice makes permanent. So practice well. Have you been practicing well? At this point, I feel echoes of much of my time teaching you. Me staring at a screen, waiting for you to respond. You afraid to unmute yourself. Maybe embarrassed that you don't have the right answers. Maybe just awkward silence. Let's interrupt this with the picture of my children. We had a new baby in May. I hope you can all come and see her sometime. Her name is Clara Abigail, and she's the most beautiful treasure God has given us yet. But let's move on. To infinity and beyond, you say. Of course, you must be talking about the Pixar film from my childhood.
Principal Decker, I'm starting to feel old.
Or maybe one of the three sequels, various other spin-offs, short films, plays, musicals, video games, and merchandise. But surely you were not influenced by this $3+ billion industry. I know the truth about why you chose that aim. Not the one where the class officers were sitting in a room and your sponsor told you the class needed an aim. Not the one where you scrolled through the first dozen Google search hits for graduation aims and picked one at random. No, I think the truth is that your Adventist education is working. Your math teachers cemented this word infinity in your vocabulary, gave it a solid definition as that quantity which cannot be measured, no matter how clever you were at counting or drawing pictures. Then, I hope, they flexed your definition when you learned that there are multiple infinities, some bigger than others. I love math so much, I have to tell you about a special application of infinity called Gabriel's horn. You'll learn about this in calculus, probably.
You are going to make me extra proud and take calculus, right?
You take this function 1 over x and restrict its domain to all the numbers 1 and greater, and then you spin it around the x-axis, forming a sort of horn. Now in calculus, the integral is the most beautiful tool to help you find areas and volumes. And you can use this tool to find the volume of the horn. I won't tell you the answer, because that would be cheating, but it's somewhere between 3 and 4. If you use the same tool and try to find the surface area, it turns out to be infinite. How can this be? In practical terms, you can take paint and pour it into this horn and fill it up with a finite amount of paint. But all the paint in this universe can't paint the inside of it. What a paradox. Doesn't it strike you with wonder that a single math problem, simple in terms of what you can do in math, leads to infinity and to a paradox? The infinite from the finite. I think God did this on purpose. Whenever you find one of these surprising results, you ought to pause and turn your heart to God and say, "Ah, I see what you did there." It's an echo of the infinite paradox. God becoming man, divinity putting on the clothes of humanity, life itself dying. Why would he do that? I hope you will think about this often. Think about this gift of God. Life eternal to infinity and beyond. I want to take a moment to think about that phrase, to infinity and beyond. If the only place you have seen it or heard it was in popular culture, I may have to be the one to break the bad news to you. This world doesn't even get to infinity, let alone beyond. But let's get right to the point at hand. Here you are, ready to receive your diplomas, waiting to launch yourselves out on the world. Or maybe you've fallen behind and you aren't sure what comes next. You don't have a college or career picked out. The future is unknown, uncertain. What's next? Is your aim really to infinity and beyond? There is no infinity on this earth. Even the known universe has an expiration date, according to the scientists. So where does this idea come from? Infinity. Is it just wishful thinking, like breathing underwater without an air tank or walking through walls? I don't think so. I think God put this in our hearts, this longing for infinity, to remind us that there is something bigger and better than what we see right now. I think he put it there to turn our hearts toward the infinite, the God who has no end. The infinite is real, just not real like what you see in front of you. Let me put it this way. We had to develop a whole new set of tools in mathematics to understand the infinite. Before that, people had some small guesses or intuition about it, but it wasn't until Leibniz and Newton developed the language and methods of calculus that we could really study it in depth. A few people caught on right away, but it took a long time to spread and be accepted by the world. If it was only 400 years ago that happened, why do people today think it's so absurd that there might be a bigger, deeper infinite in our daily life that we just don't have the language and methods to study yet? God authored it. People all around the world have had some small guesses or intuition about it. I think some are even on the right track. I think that this is what Paul means in 1 Corinthians 13, where he says, "For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I will know, even as I am known." A few people caught on, but it has taken time to spread. You, friends, have gone through Adventist education to learn about this infinite God, then to go out and spread the good news that we can be a part of the infinite through Jesus. So what are you going to do about it? Your future, that is. You should consider two parts to this question. Where are you going in the end? And how are you going to get there? First, let us establish the end. Let me show you the end that I want. He will swallow up death for all time, and the Lord God will wipe tears away from all faces, and he will remove the reproach of his people from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. And it will be said in that day, "Behold, this is our God, for whom we have waited, that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation." And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is among men, and he will dwell among them, and they shall be his people, and God himself will be among them. And he will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will no longer be any death. There will no longer be any mourning or crying or pain. The first things have passed away." Then he showed me a river of the water of life, clear as crystal, coming from the throne of God and of the Lamb in the middle of its street. On either side of the river was the tree of life, bearing 12 kinds of fruit, yielding its fruit every month, and the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. There will no longer be any curse, and the throne of God and of the Lamb will be in it, and his bondservants will serve him, They will see his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. And there will no longer be any night, and they will not have need of the light of a lamp, nor of the light of the sun, because the Lord God will illumine them, and they will reign forever and ever. Now we are faced with the second part. How are we going to get there? How then shall we live? Here is some advice from Ellen White. We have nothing to fear for the future, except as we shall forget the way the Lord has led us in his teaching in our past history. Paul says in Philippians, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, will guard your hearts and your mind in Christ Jesus. David says, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord, trust also in him, and he will do it. Another one from Ellen White in The Desire of Ages. Worry is blind and cannot discern the future, but Jesus sees the end from the beginning. In every difficulty, he has his way prepared to bring relief. Our Heavenly Father has 1,000 ways to provide for us, of which we know nothing. Those who accept the one principle of making the service and honor of God supreme will find perplexities vanish and a plain path before their feet. Clear enough? I can't tell you where you should walk, just how. Let me give you 6 pieces of practical advice that has helped me since I graduated. Number 1, stop worrying. I hope you were paying attention to the quotes I just read. Set your priorities straight and let God take care of the rest. Number 2, wealth will not fix your problems. Many of the most content people I have ever met were the poorest. I know this may be difficult to hear in Hong Kong. Nearly everything around you says wealth is the key. Isn't that the greeting around New Year's? You wish your friends and relatives wealth and prosperity in the new year? You can't help but notice all the Lamborghinis and Maseratis and Bentleys and Teslas on the roads. I'm sure if you had one, it would make you feel good. But it doesn't fill that longing in your heart for contentment. This is advice from the wisest and richest man in all the world. He was so rich that he made silver to be as common in the capital Jerusalem as stones were. Do not weary yourself to gain wealth. Cease from your consideration of it. When you set your eyes on it, it is gone, for wealth certainly makes itself wings like an eagle that flies toward the heavens. Number 3, slow down in this fast-paced world. Refuse instant gratification. These two go together, and I hope you'll see how. David says in the Psalms, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Another translation says, cease striving and know that I am God. Stop your fighting. Stop going so fast. And in another psalm, wait for the Lord. Be strong and let your heart take courage. Yes, wait for the Lord. Number 5, keep your friends close. Not just the people you like, but the ones who love you and care enough for you that they will sometimes offend you. It's in your class text, as iron sharpens iron, so one person sharpens another. This is not always a smooth and happy process, but it is necessary. Number 6, fear God. Again, words from the wisest man in all the world. The conclusion when all has been heard is this: fear God and keep his commandments, because this applies to every person. For God will bring every act to judgment, everything which is hidden, whether it is good or evil. And finally, I have 3 points of caution for you. Number 1, logic can help. I think logic must be my 2nd favorite subject in all of math, right behind counting. I love counting. Start with sound principles. Beware of what seem to be logical results that come from false premises. You remember the syllogism from geometry, right? It only works if A is true. You can't go backwards and say, since C is true, then A must also be true. If you do that, your math teachers will come and knock on your door and quietly frown at you. You have struggled through these complicated subjects in school so that you would have the tools to understand and make wise decisions in this world. Don't throw that away. Number two, paradox may not mean contradiction. Remember Gabriel's horn? It is a paradox that something could have finite volume but infinite surface area. But does it disprove reality? Even worse, does it disprove calculus or math in general? I don't think so. I think it shows us the limitations of our practical understanding of the infinite. This point is important. My lack of understanding does not prove the thing wrong. You will find some of the things of God confusing, and probably some offensive. Is that his fault? Does that prove him wrong, or that he doesn't exist? No. It shows how much more we have to learn and grow. Perhaps it shows us that we don't have the tools and vocabulary to understand the infinite yet. And number three, God is not a celestial vending machine. He loves you, not works for you. If God does not give you exactly what you ask for, when you ask for it, relax, put your priorities in order, and trust that he knows best. One final quote from one of the wisest men that I've ever met. I hope you remember this. Heaven is the school from which we will never graduate. Don't be offended. Think about it. No final exams, no marching practice, just learning to infinity and beyond. Well, this is the end. You have had the education and the training. Now you have some parting words from your dear old math teacher. Now it is your turn. I pray that God will bless you as you begin a new stage in your journey, and that you will choose to follow him wherever he leads you. I hope to see you all again sometime soon. But if not here on this earth, let's plan to get together when Jesus comes to take us all home. Thank you.
Hi, good morning everyone. It is my honor to be here today. We have had a weird high school experience. For more than half of our high school life, we had to deal with COVID and online classes. We couldn't go on more mission trips, no field trips, and in fact, I can't even recognize faces when they have their masks off. Under this kind of such situation, we still all managed to pass our AP classes and exams. In insane subjects like physics, pre-calc, and chemistry, we all should be so proud. I think most of our class was in APUSH, and the course was mainly taught online, and it felt impossible by the time we took the AP exam. I spent hours each night reading textbooks that I couldn't understand, and we had to practice writing the longest essays in the shortest amount of time. I would never have time to do the synthesis paragraph, but Amanda would always have time to draw. At the same time, I remember walking out of the testing center with Christine and Emmanuel. We all felt like we would fail, but we all passed, but Emmanuel got a 5. I don't know how. And maybe because Ms. Burke always calls him a smart cookie and he was so motivated. Y'all should really try AP classes, they're fun. And now I would like to take a moment on behalf of myself and all of my fellow graduates just to thank the people who have brought us here. Thanks to all the parents and families and friends. Without the love and support from y'all, we won't be able to be here today. And thank you to all the teachers and staff members that spend so much time and effort on teaching us and encouraging us on a daily basis. Finally, I think I'm supposed to give some kind of tips to the rest of the student body. And I just wanted to say that school isn't so hard. Just pay attention in class and finish your homework by yourself and you'll do fine. And thank you, I love you all.
Vice Principal Gudavalli, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present to you the graduating class of 2022. And with this class, I would also like to include Daniel Respin, who is in Russia and did our greeting this morning and is watching our program. Churesan Amanda. La Vinky. Lee Kuan Yang. Linnell Johnster Josh. Tang Zefeng. Zhang Yuting. Margie Joshua. Chao Shui Wen Zoe.
Congratulations, class of 2022. Very proud of you guys. You have seen that some of our graduates are wearing special regalia. They're wearing different cords and medals, and they look very pretty and beautiful in them. However, there's one award here that they can't wear on them. Okay, it's called the Harold Award. Harold is our school mascot, So we're starting this award starting this year, 2022. So each year, the award goes to one elementary student, one middle school student, and one high school student that exhibits, that best exhibits our school values. Let me quickly read out our school values to you so that you know why this award is being given. This award is given to a student that best exhibits our school values, which are compassion, respectfulness, integrity, excellence, collaboration, reflection, and adaptability. I know that all of you have displayed that. Not this award doesn't just go to the graduating, it's not just dedicated for the graduating class. It can be for any student from grade 9 through 12. And it was very difficult to make the choice because several of our students exhibit these values on a regular basis, on a daily basis. But it has to be given to one student, and the student that is chosen to receive this award happens to be from the graduating class. And that award goes to Joseph. Joseph, please come forward.
Graduates, congratulations. You have achieved an academic success in graduating from 12th grade, and I want to congratulate you. I am so sorry that I am not able to be with you. I had meetings in America that I just could not get back from in time for the graduation. In 1980, I left the familiarity and the confidence of my high school campus, and I walked onto this campus. I was nervous, even scared. How would I do academically? How would I do socially? Would I meet the girl that I would marry and spend the rest of my life with? Would I have good friends? Would I get a good job when I finish? Lots of questions, lots of doubts. On the campus of HKAA, my goal for you has been twofold: to mature academically and to establish in your life a foundation that, one, you are valued by God and by others, and second, that you are called to share and to love others using those values. For me, it happened on this campus in my college years. You see this building right behind me? This was my religion building. The theology department was in that building. And on this college campus, I pursued my academics, and I did well in some of my courses. I actually failed one of my courses, and I had to repeat it. Classes were harder, no question. Required reading was exponentially more. But what really happened to me as a person was I began to live out the values that I had begun to embrace as an adult. During your middle and high school years, you have embraced values. Values that that we have taught you at HKAA are values like compassion, respectfulness, integrity, and excellence, collaboration, reflection, adaptability. It was here on this campus, in those years in my college life, that I set the trajectory for my life. One of my professors and I began a volunteer program that had three branches. We began it in this building. That's where we started it, right there. The first branch was feeding the homeless, and there were homeless in this area that we would feed each week. The second branch was tutoring elementary students from very poor families, And the third branch was setting up a big brother and big sister for children of single parent families. I served in these programs for 3 years, taking what could have been a very self-centered existence and refocusing it on serving others. My last 2 years in college, I'll change my view now. My last 2 years in college, I spent much of my days in this building right here. This building was a hospital, and I actually served as a chaplain in that hospital at the age of 20 and 21. And every day for 3 or 4 hours, I would go in to visit patients. Some were sick, some were dying. I actually was the pastor at 21 funerals before I was 21 years old. I was learning the joy of dedicating my life to the values of service. What will be your values as you solidify the focus of your adulthood? It begins now. What the world would have you value is money, status, fancy cars, and big homes. Jesus would have you value what HKAA has tried to demonstrate to you as being valuable: compassion, respectfulness, integrity, excellence, collaboration, reflection, and adaptability. Life doesn't always go the way you want it to. You have to be adaptable. The choice is yours, what you will value. And in these next 4 to 6 years, you will basically lock in those values for much of your adulthood. Choose wisely. Be intentional. How you choose now will either leave you feeling empty and unfulfilled, or your life will be filled with meaning and with joy. May God bless you as you choose your values and as you live those values out in service and in love to others. I miss you, and we will miss you next year at school. We will miss you. May God bless you.
So I understand that the program says that there's supposed to be 4 of us, but I decided to take one for the team, and it's all right. So this is kind of hard for me because I'm not even sure if my parents are watching, but I'll try to finish this before I start crying again. To all our parents present at our graduation, whether online, through the live stream, or in person, we want to thank you sincerely for helping us get this far. We completely understand that raising us was not easy, whether we were kids or even when we were a bit older. You have instilled in us a deep desire to learn and seek higher pursuits in life, to the point where our goal is to go infinity and beyond. Without your love, care, and support, we would not have come to this moment. To the parents who are here physically, we want to recognize you for your commitment to your child's education and academic journey. You have given and sacrificed time to commemorate your child's success, and the fact that you are here today shows that you believe in us. To those who have become like family to us when we have been stranded here due to the pandemic, we want to sincerely thank you from the bottom of our hearts for being there with us when we found it hard without our family. As one of the many students in the graduating class whose parents are unable to attend physically, I understand how bittersweet this moment might be to see your child graduate, but be unable to tell them how proud you are of them and give them a big hug.
But without your decision to send us to this school and the many struggles throughout both the pandemic and the distance between us, we wouldn't be standing here today. Without all of you, we would not be able to receive one of the best gifts of all, education. You have supported us, believed in us, and cheered us all the way, and we owe our success to you. We have prepared a short video for the parents, and we hope you enjoy a walk down memory lane. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. Good morning, parents, teachers, and my fellow graduates, or should I say, my family. We're all here today, seated in our majestic gowns, finally at the end of our high school career. Needless to say, my experiences in high school was not how I envisioned in High School Musical, though it was better than what I anticipated. I would like to share a very special video to you all, especially to my dear classmate who has been with me since grade 9. We have come a long way now. No words can express how much we have been through together. Not even a diploma can express the bond we have over the last 4 years. Moreover, this graduation is not only to look at the future, but also to look at the past. Since the future is unpredictable, I prefer to walk down the memory lane of our moments together and the hardship we've been through, and we can see all the things we have come so far. Those we can look back on when we're in our 40s and think, wow, really made it. We even survived a pandemic. But all jokes aside, memories are like a thread of knots. Here. Memories are like a thread of knots. When one knot are tied together, you cannot untie it without triggering the other knots. Therefore, when memories are all stringed together, it can also help string us to the future and bring us memories to the future as well. We can trace from one start of the memory to the end, feeling the lumps of small memory on its way, reminiscing the life we have in high school. Let this thread remain with us forever, tangled with memories, and we can live on and grow further. Thank you, and enjoy the video.
Through the door with you, the air was cold, but something about it felt like home somehow, and I left my scarf there at your sister's house, and you've still got it in your drawer. Falling down like pieces into place, and I can picture it after all.
it's like I'm paralyzed by it. I'd like to be my old self again, but I'm still trying to find it after bad shadows. That's when you made me your own. Now you mail back my things and I walk home alone. But you keep my own scars
from the very first week.
Cause it reminds you of innocence. It smells like me.
Good morning, graduates of 2020, Principal Decker, who's not here though, teachers, parents, and honorable guests. I want to start today by congratulating you people for making it. The last 2 years has been challenging because of the pandemic, whether it was getting used to online classes or wearing a mask in general. But you have overcome these challenges, which shows that you have developed the resilience to overcome hardship, which is very important. I graduated from HKAA last year, but I did not go to a university. Instead, I took a gap year. However, university education is vital, and I want to be better prepared for myself. Since September, I have worked as a volunteer in organizations and worked for a salary in tutorial centers to gain work experience. I've also spent a lot of time studying for public exams to be better prepared in the eyes of the university. As an alumni of this school, I want to tell you that HKAA can serve as a springboard for your future life, but it is for you and it is only up to you to act appropriately and strive for it. As life continues, no one will remind you what your responsibilities are, when the deadline is due, or what you should do every day. So you will have to be the one to do it, to master self-discipline. Eventually, everyone has their own path, and there's no need to copy what others are doing. There's no need for anxiety, even when your path is different from everyone else. Just be yourself. As my speech ends, the takeaway is that you should use your experience as your foundation. You should be self-disciplined, and most importantly, you should remember that your future entails endless possibilities. Thank you.
Let's all rise for our benediction. Let's pray. Our dear Father in Heaven, Lord, we thank you for this moment right here, a time for us to celebrate, for us graduates, that we actually made it here. But we all know once we go to our different paths, we will start our new journey, our new life, to even level up, to become adults. Lord, even though that we may have to go in our separate ways, you know that you will be with us. You know our future. You know our plans despite of our uncertainties. Lord, we ask you also that you help us remember to always hoist ourselves and to always go infinity and beyond. Lord, we ask you that you will be with each one of us. We thank you also for guiding us with all throughout all the hurdles, despite of the challenges, even when things have gone really hard for us. But it made us all who we are right now, and we have sharpened ourselves to face bigger challenges in our future. Thank you for our friends and families, and also to our teachers that always be with us. And thank you, Lord, for everything. We ask you to forgive our sins. Pray, amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the class is going to go and take their class photo right now, but if you want to take photos with them afterwards, you can meet in the MPH, that's the bottom area of the dorm.